Unfiltered team wants to wish Ben Rhodes, former Obama senior advisor, a big congratulations. I mean, I assume he must have won Powerball because he seems totally unconcerned with being hired again by anyone. Last night, fellow former Obama advisor Dan Pfeiffer tweeted, "This photo of President Trump, Vice President Pence, Paul Ryan, and Mitch McConnell celebrating the passage of the Republican tax bill, saying, I hope this is the photo they use on the front page of the Times on the day Trump is indicted." Okay, a little dramatic, but okay. But then Rhodes responded, and alongside the obits for Ryan, McConnell, and Pence. You heard that right. Ben Rhodes, a former Obama official, just openly fantasized about the deaths of three prominent politicians. Hey, Ben, I mean this sincerely. Try therapy. You do not seem well. He's not alone, however. Many on the left seem to have lost all sense of reality and decency this year. I know Trump was a big blow to a lot of liberal and some conservative faith in the country, but let's not jump off a collective cliff. Where were you when you saw this tweet by Ben Rhodes? Can we start there? Because I know exactly where I was, and I did one of these. What? This can't be. Surely he means this metaphorically. I mean, how crazy, stupid, awful, terrible, unacceptable is this?
Yeah, it's really bad. I don't want to, but I think there's an argument to be made to give him the benefit of the doubt.
I'm sorry, what?
That he meant political obits. But I feel like,
because you know how because newspapers don't have political obits.
No, they have actual obits. But like you said, speaking metaphorically, the thing is, I don't buy it because we have 280 characters now, and he easily could have said political obits.
So his background is in creative writing.
Yeah,
that is what he does. Yeah.
He is a propagandist. This was propaganda, straight, pure and simple. But how gross and how far have people like Ben Rhodes gone down this rabbit hole of, you know, kind of F it, I'm going to say anything.
Yeah, but what infuriates me about kind of the left-wing culture, the anti-Trump culture in America, is that while they use this incredibly hyperbolic, you know, language, they're also the offended police.
Right.
So,
right.
Anyone on the other side says anything that offends them, you know, they're concerned with microaggressions. And yet at the same time, they can do this.
Well, and Steve Scalise, I'm sure you all remember the Republican congressman who was shot at a congressional baseball game practice, tweeted, "You may want to reconsider your rhetoric." I mean, it doesn't get a great response. It doesn't get any more pointed than that.
I mean, the thing that's really sort of shocking about this is Trump has a great many gifts, and one of them is that he has the ability to make those around him reveal the price of their dignity. But even weirder than the ability to make his subordinates completely submit themselves to him is his ability to take people who formerly cut their teeth wearing hair shirts while flagellating themselves and saying, this is not who we are.
Right.
Drags them down with him into the mud. And now they're saying the most vicious, weird, wild stuff that previously would have been unimaginable from these people. But I guess it was always there under the surface. And Trump just brings it out.
That's it, right there. I mean, that's the thing about Trump. It's like, you know, you can feel however you feel about him.
He gives them immunity almost, right? They feel like, A, this president said some pretty not politic stuff. B, they hate him and they think he's hateable. And C, there is no punishment. So they do have immunity.
There's also a very well-developed incentive structure out there to write things like that, especially on social media, and then watch and wait for the dopamine hit as the retweets come in. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you look at the tweet that he was responding to, that one too, it wasn't violent, but it was also over the top.
Yes, completely.
There is a contingent within the United States that has decided that Donald Trump is going to be indicted and removed from office. Maybe he will be. I don't know. We don't know what's happened with Russia. We don't know what the result of the inquiry will be. But they've already decided that that is true. And when you get to that point,
very foolish.
Well, it is foolish, but it also breeds this incentive structure, because if he is a Russian agent, as Dan Pfeiffer seems to think he is, then it's okay to talk about him like that.
But what
do we do to Russian agents? We execute them.
That's right, right? That's right. Well, let's go through some of the other totally unhinged tweets from this past year. We talked about this, I think, last night. Rosie O'Donnell is not well, okay? She's not okay. Here's what she tweeted about the healthcare bill. How about this? I promise to give $2 million to Senator Susan Collins, $2 million to Senator Jeff Flake if they vote no. No, I will not kill Americans for the super rich, I think she means. I mean, she's been on a tear. Neera Tanden, who is a Democratic operative, very close in Hillary Clinton's circles, upon learning that forest fires were close to Rupert Murdoch's home in Los Angeles. Rupert Murdoch, the head of News Corp, tweeted, "There is a God, and she's unhappy." And then tweeted again, "I don't hope for such things. I just note the karma." That's crazy. She ended up taking it down, said she felt bad about it. Don't think she did. Mm-hmm. But
she's also lying. She does hope for such things.
Yeah, that's what I mean. She's not. She doesn't feel bad about it. Right. I think she meant it. Right. And I think in her world, this liberal, super, you know, activist, you know, resistance world, mm-hmm. that she thought she could get away with it. That people would pat her on the back
well,
for
and
it.
And the thing is, look, when you view yourself as good with a capital G,
yeah.
and the people who disagree with you or whom you oppose as evil with a capital E, then you can say and do things like this. Mm-hmm. You know, if your heart is in the right place, you can't do anything wrong.
Right, right, right.
So yeah, so you know, Ben Rhodes can sit there and he can feel like he can do that because in his mind and in the minds of a lot of people on the left, Paul Ryan, Mitch McConnell, those people, they are evil.
Yes.
And what's wrong
He's
with
fighting
wishing
the good fight.
What's wrong with right. wishing death on evil?
Yeah,
but
right,
it also
right.
doesn't make much sense. I mean, if there is a God who is sending forest fires to punish the character of the people in a certain area. I mean, she just sent it to Hollywood. I mean, it was funny. Neera Tanden put that tweet out, and underneath it, the next tweet was Chelsea Handler saying that she was having to evacuate because of the forest
right,
fires.
Right, right.
If they'd sent it to, Awful. You know, the NRA headquarters, it might have been funnier for her, right. not for me.
Right.
But she didn't even think through the consequences of her tweet.
And that's precisely it. A lot of the sort of resistance thing shows this lack of introspection or thinking on their part. It's just this mad, spittle-flecked rage, which, looking ahead at 2018 or 2020, yeah, there seems to be a groundswell for Democratic candidates, but this sort of lack of thinking through their strategy speaks not to just 2016, but to the future. Honestly, I don't think Trump won for any one thing Trump did. I think he won because the people he went up against were hysterically incompetent and don't think through what they say or
well,
do, and don't differentiate
just
themselves.
The danger of an old wives tale, old chestnut, the boy who cried wolf. Sure, I mean, the more they talk like this, I think the more people see it as noise and like, you're faking us out. Like,
right.
Listen to Nancy Pelosi on the tax bill.
No, it is the end of the road. This health care, the debate on health care is life, death. This is Armageddon.
Worse than life and death.
I don't. Yeah. You almost couldn't hear her first word. She said, no, this is the end of the world.
Right. How do they differentiate themselves from Trump in terms of hyperbole, going over the board? There's no real difference between
them. But they don't. Maybe they don't have to.
They never are accountable for this. So like
no,
a year from now, when it's not the end of the world, there'll
someone
be something
would
else
have
that
to
is the
hold
news
them
thing.
Accountable, yes, Dave. Right. And
but again, when your heart is in the right place, you don't have to be held accountable. Also, the problem is not like Rosie O'Donnell. Rosie O'Donnell is crazy, and she's
and
the problem is all these people who are not supposed to be crazy sound like Rosie O'Donnell.
Yes, I mean, look, Neera Tanden, Ben Rhodes, Brian Fallon. I mean, these were establishment Democrats.
Yeah.
They are Democrat operatives. They are supposed to be like the saner, cooler heads.
Yeah.
I don't know what's happening. Okay, coming up, taking names and kicking the Trump administration fires back at the UN.